We're all about 2020. You just wanted Joe Biden out. What's your response?
Well, I don't know him. I don't know Parnas, other than I guess I had pictures taken, which I do with thousands of people, including people today that I didn't meet, but just met him. I don't know him at all. Don't know what he's about. Don't know where he comes from. Know nothing about him. I can only tell you this thing is a big hoax. It's a big hoax. We call it, this is the current hoax. We've gone through the Russian witch hunt. We've gone through a lot of them from probably before I came down the escalator, but certainly since I came down the escalator, you take a look at what's happened. And in the meantime, our country, it doesn't matter what he's doing. He's trying to probably make a deal for himself. I don't even know who this man is, other than I guess he attended fundraisers, so I take a picture with him. I'm in a room. I take pictures with people. I take thousands and thousands of pictures with people all the time, thousands during the course of a year. Oftentimes I'll be taking a picture with somebody. I'll say, I wonder what newspaper that one's going to appear in. No, I don't know him. Perhaps he's a fine man. Perhaps he's not. I know nothing about him. But I can tell you this.
More than just taking pictures with President. He says that
I don't know him. I don't believe I've ever spoken to him.
On the phone with Giuliani, and he said,
I don't believe I've ever spoken to him. I meet thousands of people. I meet thousands and thousands of people as president. I take thousands of pictures. And I do it openly, and I do it gladly. And then if I have a picture where I'm standing with somebody at a fundraiser, like I believe I saw a picture with this man, but I don't know him. I had never had a conversation that I remember with him.
So when
certainly, let me just tell you, you just have to take a look at the polls. Quiet. You just have to take a look at the pictures. You just have to take a look at the polls. You see, I don't need anybody's help. We're doing phenomenally well. The economy is the best it's ever been. We have never had an economy like this in history. We just made the two best trade deals in the history of our country. We are doing well. I don't need the help of a man that I never met before, other than perhaps taking a picture at a fundraiser.
Nearly a dozen times. Trump denied knowing Lev Parnas nearly a dozen times in 2 minutes. And if you know anything about Donald Trump, what that tells you is that he definitely knows who Lev Parnas is. His denials came on the heels of the bombshell allegations leveled against him by the former Giuliani associate. Parnas appeared on Rachel Maddow's show and said that despite Trump claiming ignorance about Giuliani's efforts to help him extort Ukraine, the president knew exactly what was happening.
What do you think is the main inaccuracy or the main lie that's being told that you feel like you can correct?
That the president didn't know what was going on. President Trump knew exactly what was going on. He was aware of all of my movements. I wouldn't do anything without the consent of Rudy Giuliani or the president.
In terms of the president and what he has said about you, he said about you and Mr. Fruman, Igor Fruman, I don't know those gentlemen, I don't know about them, I don't know what they do. You're saying that was not a true statement from the president?
He lied.
Now, luckily for us, Trump deigned to take some time away from his prayer event today, which, knowing Donald Trump, must have been really difficult for him. Notwithstanding the fact that the guy's had more affairs than most people have had relationships in their entire lives, just take a look at what this, quote, prayer event actually entailed. On the table in front of him is his 2016 electoral map by county. We are 3 years into this term, and the President of the United States, a full-grown man, physically cannot help but bring his safety blanket, his big red map, into meetings in the Oval Office. Honestly though, who could have guessed that an event surrounding prayer wouldn't be enough to hold Donald Trump's attention? Now, despite Trump's super persuasive technique of desperately denying over and over again that he's ever met the guy, Parnas was decidedly unimpressed.
Did you think you were friends?
Absolutely. I mean, again, I went from being a top donor, from being at all the events where we would just socialize, to becoming a close friend of Rudy Giuliani's, to eventually becoming his ally and his asset on the ground in Ukraine.
The president has said, when you were arrested, the president of the United States said he didn't know you.
I don't know those gentlemen. Now, it's possible I have a picture with them because I have a picture with everybody. I don't know them.
The truth is out now, thank God. Yesterday was a big day for us. I thank God every day. I was worried that that day is not going to come. I thought they were going to shut me up, make me look like the scapegoat, and try to blame me for stuff that I wasn't done. But with God's help and a great legal team that I have besides me, we were able to get the information out, and now it's out there. So I welcome him to say that even more. Every time he says that, I'll show him another picture.
He's lying.
He's lying.
And so basically what we're left with at this point is that it's really a matter of who you believe. And on one side we have Parnas, who's released countless photos of himself and Donald Trump, who was a known and close associate of Rudy Giuliani, who was literally carrying out a mission in Ukraine that Trump himself was hell-bent on achieving, and whose activities were validated when Pence's attendance at Zelensky's inauguration was revoked after Zelensky didn't grant Parnas the announcement of the Biden probe that he was seeking for Trump. And on the other side is Donald Trump, who recently lied about the path of a hurricane because his ego wouldn't allow him to admit that he made a mistake. Tough choices. But this is what Trump does. He doesn't even try to alter his strategy for distancing himself when his criminal accomplices inevitably get picked off. He said Paul Manafort, his campaign chairman, quote, came into the campaign very late and was with us for a short period of time. He called George Papadopoulos, his foreign policy advisor, a quote, low-level volunteer. The White House said that Trump and Steve Bannon, his chief strategist, were not, quote, particularly close. And most recently, Trump said that he, quote, hardly knows Gordon Sondland, his campaign's donor of $1 million, who he then installed as ambassador to the European Union and spoke directly with on the phone to discuss Ukraine. If Don Jr. ever ratted out his father, guaranteed Trump would pretend he never met the guy and swear up and down that he only has 4 kids. Here's the thing, Trump's denials carry no weight. He has spent months gaslighting the American people, pretending that all the evidence against him somehow doesn't exist. We have the corroborated whistleblower complaint showing that he asked Zelensky for the personal favor of an investigation into the Bidens. We know that Trump withheld $391 million in military assistance from Ukraine, which the Government Accountability Office announced today was in violation of the law, what's known as the Impoundment Control Act, wherein the president is not allowed to substitute his own policy priorities for those that Congress has already enacted into law. We know that Trump anointed Rudy Giuliani to act as a shadow State Department to facilitate the investigation into the Bidens. We've heard from firsthand witnesses like Gordon Sondland, who admitted that not only was Giuliani acting at the direction of the president, but that satisfying Giuliani's demands was a condition for any official relationship between the United States and Ukraine. We know that Marie Yovanovitch was removed from her post, apparently after being physically surveilled by another one of Giuliani's goons, for her unwillingness to play along in this illegal extortion scheme. The list goes on and on. And just as Trump has denied all of this every step of the way, so has his credibility regarding anything to do with Ukraine completely vanished. So he can pretend that he's never met Lev Parnas, but at this point, when it comes to Trump, his denials are basically just admissions of guilt.